Tattoos have been around for ages, yet slowly becoming more and more popular in Western culture over the last decades. An interesting development in this is the sudden rise of facial tattoos in recent years. But what do these Japanese prints have to do with that? Welcome to Is This Art, where we take a closer look at pop culture and try to answer the age-old question, is this art? Some of today's most popular artists, especially young rappers, are heavily inked. In some cases, they are literally covered from head to toe. These tattoos can be viewed as a statement of self-expression, saying something like, I will not conform to society, or this is me, deal with it. But when we take a closer look at the individual tattoos, we notice a variety of styles, sometimes combining thousands of years of tattoo traditions. One style in particular that has an important connection with art history is Japanese traditional. Why did that become so popular? In Western culture, tattoos seem to be a modern phenomenon. But, as you might know, tattoos have been around for thousands of years. The term tattoo is said to be derived from the Tahitian word tattoo, meaning stripe, mark, or spot. The oldest example of a person with tattoos was found on the famous ice mummy Ötzi. His body was preserved over 5,000 years ago in the ice of the Italian Alps. On his skin, archaeologists discovered 59 tattoos. From ancient Egyptians to the ancient Greeks and Maori, they all inked their skins. To these countries or cultures, tattoos all had different purposes. They could be purely aesthetic, and sometimes they were simply there to intimidate. As long as there's been trade, there's been an exchange in tattoo styles. However, the European expansions overseas and the spread of Christianity in the 15th century meant that a lot of traditional tattoo styles became almost extinct. A couple of centuries later, Western sailors played an important role in spreading the traditional tribal tattoo styles that did survive when they were returned to their home countries with similar tattoos to the ones they encountered when overseas. Tattoos have also been used in the negative sense. Slave owners would mark enslaved people as their property. Similar tattoos were given in concentration camps during the Second World War by tattooing a number on the forearms of their prisoners. In a way, taking away their human identity. And then there's a tradition amongst gangs and criminals to intimidate and show what group or gang they belong to through their ink. A connotation that a lot of people still have with tattoos today. There are three main trends in tattooing. 1. Tribal tattoos, derived from the traditional tribal tattoos from the Polynesian people, for example. 2. Classical American and nautical tattoos, a tradition that became popular among Western sailors. 3. Traditional Japanese tattoos. Let's dive into those some more. Look at these tattoos. We see some clear Japanese motifs. We see carbs, waves, geishas. These are distinctly derived from Japanese culture, which has always appealed to the West. Since the very start of the trade between West and East, our longing for spirituality and mysticism is something that we have projected upon our perception of Japan. We see proof of this in the different art historical trends of the past centuries. Just look at Van Gogh's Japanese period, for example. Japanese tattooing traditions were mainly associated with the criminal underworld until the 18th century, when artists first became interested in the art of tattooing. From the 19th century up to the 21st century, Japanese tattoos were highly fashionable among higher layers of society. Even Western royals got a tattoo by famous tattoo artists when visiting Japan. In 19th century Japan, popularity of tattoos also rose thanks to the prints of woodblock artists like Kuniyoshi. Kuniyoshi was highly popular, and his heroic mythical images were transferred almost completely onto the bodies of Japanese workers, men and women alike. It was believed that one could inherit the bravery of those portrayed heroes. Completing a tattoo like this could take years and are undoubtedly inspired by the prints of Kuniyoshi. In Japan, another tattooing trend was very popular, decorational motifs such as tigers and dragons. This caught on as a way to disguise tattoos on the body, which were placed there as punishment for criminals. This was before the trend of the full-body mythical hero tattoos. With the invention of photography, travelers from Europe were able to take these trends back home. There are some really cool photo albums from that era in the collection of the Rijksmuseum, where we see pictures like this. a postman covered with one of these Kuniyoshi-style tattoos. Back to all of these heavily inked bodies of rap artists. They are walking examples of thousands of years of tattooing tradition. But what influences can we discover? Take Lil Wayne. Much like painters and other artists, rap artists of today are pushing boundaries by getting parts of their bodies inked that were viewed as off-limits in the West for a long time. Their hands, neck, and face. In doing so, they are slowly turning their entire bodies into canvases. This brings up the question, is this art? We'll let you decide. Let us know whether you think tattoos are art or not, and let us know your suggestions for future episodes of Is This Art? Thanks for watching!